This is Dr. Carmen Bryan. This is Overcoming Narcissist Abuse. Thank you guys so much for joining me. And thank you guys so much for your subscription. Thank you for all the comments and even requests for videos. I appreciate you guys. Make sure you check out my other video concerning the conference that's coming up on July 31st. We'll talk about it at the end of the video. Today, I wanted to talk about, let's see, I don't have a title for the video yet, but by the time you get to the video and start listening to it, you know I'll have a title for it at the time. But I really wanted to talk about the argumentative part, not the argumentative, but the arguments that you're having with the narcissist let me think for a minute. Let me add something in there. Let me see how to put it. The projection, the wordplay. You may know it as word salad, but you know, the wordplay, the denial in a conversation or the argument. First of all, you got to understand that when you're dealing with a narcissist is not a normal person. We know that. We know that they have psychological problems, and that psychological problem is in the form of personality disorders. You have mental health issues, you have behavior issues, you have emotional issues, then you have personality disorders or issues. And these individuals have a flawed character. They have a flawed character because they've been through something. Something has happened in their developmental stages that has caused them to develop abnormally. And so their personality has developed abnormally. It's like an autoimmune disorder that has developed, and it is fighting its own self. You know, so the autoimmune autoimmune disorders fights the body. So it fights, you know, when it doesn't... It doesn't help itself, it fights itself. And that narcissist fights itself. And when it fights itself, you know, that personality, when they fight it themselves, they pull you all into fighting themselves. Anytime you get into an argument with a narcissist. Now, number one, a narcissist needs a fuel. They need fuel. It was in my last video. Listen to it. But a narcissist needs fuel. So if they're not being idealized, if you're not telling them how wonderful they are, oh, you wonderful, beautiful, wonderful, handsome, wonderful, sexy, wonderful thing that you are, and thank you, and oh my gosh, there's only so much thank yous and gratifications and oh my gosh you can give an individual. But they're so, they're an empty pit, and they need it to make them feel relevant, to make them feel important, to make them feel like, bring their self-esteem up, but it does not last. It does not last to a point where they're around maybe the primary source or whatever source supply that they're around, that they need that all the time, to a point where you get tired of doing it. Like, dang, dude, bruh. Like the kids say, bruh, I mean, dang, you mean, can you give somebody else some attention? But it's all about them. So if they can't get the positive from you, they'll try to get the negative fuel from you. So I mean, it's just starting arguments for no reason, just saying something negative about you, you know, saying something horrible or saying something disrespectful where you turn around and you just go off. So when you lose your cool, they're getting that feel because they got a reaction out of you. And then you're yelling and screaming like, you don't disrespect me like that. How many times have I told you that? So what's the first thing they do? They divert that whole conversation. They deflect. And all of a sudden it becomes, don't be yelling at me like that. Don't disrespect me like that. I know you're not talking about disrespecting. You just did this. You just did this. Oh, so what you're saying is that I just did this, but look at you now. Look at you now. Look at you now. But you see how they deflected? They turned that whole conversation on you now. Now look at you. Look at you. You're standing there screaming and yelling. You don't disrespect me. You don't disrespect me. Now, see, wait a minute. Hold on. Now you see what you're doing? But do you see? Oh my gosh, it gives me a headache just telling you about it. But you see how it just... It's a never-ending circle cycle. And then they'll even deny what they just did. You just said this about me. No, I didn't. You misunderstood what I was saying. See, you get the wrong impression. Now, you have to understand that the English language, and I'm not talking about other languages, because other languages have different dialects, and but you take this and apply this to your language. But the American language is very unique because it depends on how you say what you say. You can say a lot of things without saying a lot of things. And we deal a lot with facial expressions and body language. You know, a lot of it deals with body language. It's what is not said that's being said. The body language, the facial expressions, the inflections in the voice, the grunts, the hums, all this micro expressions. And that wasn't a micro expression. That was an obvious expression. Micro expressions, you know, the, ooh, I don't like you. No, I do like you, you know. And that micro expression, but even the inflections or certain words that you say mean one thing, but could mean another, depending on how you say it, the inflection in your voice, you know, hey girl, how you doing? Hey girl, how you doing? You in a good mood? Yeah, I'm in a good mood. I mean, I don't look like I'm in a good mood. I don't look like I'm in a good mood. No, what's wrong with you? Why you got an attitude? I don't have an attitude. Why everybody got to have an attitude? You know, as opposed to, hey, girl, how you doing? You all right? Yeah, girl, I'm all right. You ain't got no attitude, do you, girl? No, I ain't got no attitude, girl. I'm doing great. Do you see the difference? But there's a difference in your inflection in your voice, the expressions on your faces. Narcissists know how to play into that. So they do the exact same thing. They deflect. They also wordplay. Now, some of you hear the terminology word salad. Word salad, originally, what word salad is, it is a symptom of a person that has like schizophrenia, that has like psychotic disorder, schizophrenia, and it's a brain disorder. And so when they start having those word plays, normally, not word plays, but word salad, they're normally there's something wrong in their brain or their schizophrenia. That's also a sign of schizophrenia where there's just word salad and it doesn't make any sense. And there's harmonizing and humming and rhyming and, you know, so that originally word salad comes from a mental disorder. That's letting you know there's something either wrong with the brain, it's not processing correctly, or there's something like schizophrenia going on. And so I like to use the term word play. And they have a play on words. Like I was just showing you a few minutes ago, they have a play on words. So that makes you even more irritated because you're trying to have this adult conversation with an individual and or this individual that has a narcissistic personality disorder, and they're word playing. So everything that you say, they're word playing. They're adding something on it. They're reversing it, and they're deflecting. Projecting. That's another thing. You know, the projection, we talked about that in another video, you know, where they're projecting themselves onto you. And so they may have and I'm going to talk about the smear campaign on Sunday, but just to go into the smear campaign a little bit, this is usually how they set the smear campaign up, because they know that, let's say you're married, they're married or whatever, and they're interested in you, you know, so they found you attractive, they're interested in you. And so they keep coming around you, they may say something to you, but they know that if it gets out or you say anything, it makes them look guilty. So they start a smear campaign and they project how they feel about you onto you by telling people about you. And so it already sets you up in the event that you bring it out. The smear campaign has been set up to justify what they were saying in the first place and to validate or justify what you're doing and how you're doing it, you know. But we're gonna have to wait for the phone to stop. But they will smear in order to set themselves up to justify the lies that they've already told to cover themselves, because they projected their feelings onto you. So this is a never-ending cycle of, you know, conversation. And most of you drive yourself crazy, scream and yell and try to, I just don't understand why you can't understand what I'm saying. And I've tried to explain to you. I'm tired of explaining to you. And I've tried to explain it. We keep coming back to, but they're getting fuel out of it. They're watching your neck muscles, you know, get tight. They're watching those veins in your neck or the veins in your forehead pop out. And they're just, you're giving them what they need. And if you notice, they'll just calm down and they just look at you. And then while they're looking at you, like, just look at you. Look at you. You're just acting a fool. Look at you. Oh, you can't even control yourself. Look how you're acting. Look what you're doing. Look at you. Just look at you. And you're thinking like, you're the one who caused this. You're the one who's always starting something. No one is bothering you. No one is, if they have a peaceful day, they don't like peace and quiet. Person that has chaos inside of them, a person that has turmoil inside of them, a person that is bitter, a person that is upset all the time, they don't have any peace and quiet in their head. They don't have peace and quiet in their life. And so guess what? They affect everything around them. A person that is just ugly and bitter affects everybody. You can say, good morning. What's so nice about this morning? Oh my gosh, here comes Bitter Betty. You know, or girl, she done finally found her a beautiful man. Or she's found her, he's found her a beautiful woman. They're meant to be together. You could tell it's been a long time. It's been 20, 30 years. And they finally have gotten something good. It's a good, what's so good about it? Everybody's a dog. You know, it's a dog. And you know those type of people? Those are the type of people. That's a narcissist. They're never happy for anybody because I'm not the one that's causing the happiness for you. So you can't be happy with anybody. You can't be happy. What do you mean happy? Narcissist. You guys have to understand that these are not normal conversations. These are not normal people. These are not normal arguments. And any way that they can get some type of fuel out of you, they're going to get it. A lot of you try to focus on the fact, what do I do to just cut off all fuel? You'll never cut off all fuel. But what you do is you focus on yourself. Because eventually they become irrelevant. So it doesn't matter. They'll get some fuel from you. Who knows? You say hello, good morning, you're nice to them, whatever. They're going to get some fuel just out of that. It doesn't matter. But once you begin to heal and they don't matter, it doesn't matter what kind of fuel they get from you. As long as you don't fall into the loop again. But these arguments that you're in, these circumstantial arguments, circumstantial meaning going around in a circle, circumstantial thought, going around in a circle to get to the point. And sometimes they never get to the point. They just go in a circle, you know, in a circle. Sometimes they do. They go in a circle and they tell these stories, circle. And you're like, oh my God, I'm tired. And they wear you out in order to force you to agree to something that they say or want to do. Then those tangential thought or tangential conversation is when you go off on a tangent. You'll find that a lot with people that are bipolar, that have bipolar disorder or are ADHD. they can't stay focused on a topic. And so their tangential speech or tangential thought process. And so they just go off on a tangent. You ask them a question and they're 1,000 miles away and they come back and like, what was the question again? Because that's their frame of thinking. Sometimes it could be a problem with the brain itself, or it could be just a chemical imbalance, you know, or a mood disorder, you know, that caused them to go in a tangential conversation, just go off into la la land. Same thing with the narcissist. And so there's a lot of things you can find in a narcissist. You can find the symptoms of bipolar. You can find the symptoms of borderline. You can find the symptoms of schizophrenia. You can find a lot of symptoms. But that's why they're very unique individuals. And these are not normal people. And you argue and argue and argue and argue. What is the point of your argument? Say what you have to say and then leave it at that. They'll always come back and pick a stab. They'll always come back and just start stuff with you for no reason because they need some fuel. You can tell when they're empty, when they start picking on you. You can tell when they're empty and they need some fuel when they just start something out of the blue. Everything is, and some of you have said it, everything is going well. All of a sudden you pop up. You know, everything was going so great. And then all of a sudden you start arguing about nothing. You know, we were having a great time at the barbecue or the family reunion or whatever. And then you started up. You wanted some attention. Telltale signs of a narcissist, right? So thank you guys so much. I didn't want this to be a very long video at all. But hey, make sure you guys go and look on my community tab or my Facebook page or scroll down to there's two videos down there talking about the Overcoming Narcissist Abuse Conference that's coming up on July 31st. It's hidden in plain sight, exposing the secrets. You're going to have my good friend, Bridget Griffin, who is a domestic violent legal advocate for the King County, Seattle area for the YWCA. And she will be coming and having a conversation with you guys and discussions on what to say in court, what not to say in court, how to find lawyers, parental alienation. You know, a lot of things that you guys are making mistakes in the court system, or you're making mistakes in when you're going into the court and you're trying to make sure that someone understands that you're dealing with a narcissist. And she's going to have a discussion with you on what to do and what not to do, what to look for, what not to look for. Then you're going to have my big brother, Mr. Marcus Monroe. He is discussing with mentality, but he's going to be in there and he's going to be talking to you about this new group of men that are coming up and you are the target. Or these high value women, you're the target. And he's going to tell you he was a part of the group at one point in time. And thank God he got out of it. But he's here to tell you about it. He kept his character intact. He kept his personality intact. But he's here to tell you about it. And his passion is to help women. And this is coming from a male's perspective where he's coming in to help women. He's helping to talk to you, to avoid being targeted, to avoid being hurt. Because he's a narcissist raising up narcissists. And these are narcissists training men on how to handle you as a woman, as a queen. You don't want to miss it. Then you got my big sister, Kathy Gibson. My life is intentional. I love to hear her talk because her and our mother, Helen Sadler, your destiny helper, have a program on Wednesdays. They come on Wednesdays. Today is Friday. I don't know where you're at across the world. Today is Friday, June 18th, 2021. And they're coming on this evening, so you make sure that you listen. But she loves to talk about the value, our value. women's value, our value, you know, the quality of the woman, relationships, you know, having some self-esteem and self-worth. And a lot of people have lost that, especially dealing with these narcissists. But when you start understanding your value and your worth, you know, you won't be an easy target anymore when you value yourself. And she's an awesome speaker. She's awesome, 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 awesome. And then, of course, yours truly, and the one that we're waiting for, who's going to close out the conference, is our mother, my spiritual mom, my mentor, my leader, Helen Sadler, your destiny helper. And she can say whatever she wants to say when she comes on the platform. She's going to close it out. But I will be your main speaker at the conference, and I'll be talking to you guys a lot of things that you need to know. How did I get into a situation like this? Why do I keep getting into situations like that? Because it goes well beyond you here and now. It goes to how you've been groomed, molded, and raised. The parenting styles that you grew up with, and then your attachment style, your love languages, a lot of that. And then I also want to talk to you guys about manipulation, not just with narcissists, because you can apply it to a lot of people that don't have narcissistic personality disorder, but the manipulation tactics. What is it saying about them? What is it saying? What are they trying to do? What is the goal? You know, so that you are aware of it, so you don't get caught up in it all the time. And so I want to make sure that you guys are there at the conference. I have special deals going on. So you guys go to the link, just go my, you can find it right up underneath my video too. Go to the ticket link. I have group deals that are going on right now as well. So if you bring a group, it's less expensive than if you come by yourself. But we have some quality speakers on this platform, and you don't want to miss it. This is normally a $3,500 platform, but I'm giving it to you for $280 for general admission, $300 for VIP. VIP meaning it starts at 8 o'clock, it ends at 6 o'clock. In between there, everybody, as general and general admissions and VIP, we will be serving you a Greek buffet. And then for the VIPs at 7 o'clock, we have limousines to come pick you up and take you to a restaurant of my choosing so that we can get to know each other. We can talk. I get to hug you for the first time. Even at the conference, I get to hug you for the first time. I shake your hand. I get to see the faces behind the names on YouTube. And those of you that support me, I get to see you guys. I get to shake your hands. Just grab your face. If I can grab your face, give you a hug, kiss you on your forehead, you know, take pictures with you. So I am looking forward to it. Now, if you're in a group deal, if you're coming as five of you, if you have five people in your group and you're the sixth person, you, the sixth person, are the sponsor in your group, it's a $700 fee. So it's $140 per person. If you're doing a group of 10 and you're the 11th person, you are the sponsor. You take those 10 people, it's $120 for each one of those people. So I think it's a $1,200. And then you as the 11th person, you are the sponsor. So the sponsors get in free. And then if you're coming with a group of 20, you know, you're the 21st person, I think it's $2,000. It's $100 per person. The sponsor gets in free, and then all the 20 people pay $100. That is a deal. I'm telling you, it's a deal. But I got a lot of people that are online right now. Don't wait till the last minute. You know, if you can make it to Texas, come out to Texas. It is at the Hilton Dallas Lincoln Center, July 31st from 8 a.m. to 6 p.m. Tomorrow, I'm going to ask Miss Bridget Griffin if she would let me interview her. So you guys stay tuned for a live broadcast where I'm going to interview her. I'm going to talk to her. She's one of the conference speakers, of course, just said it. And for those of you that can make it out to Dallas, please come out so I can finally see you guys. And if you can't come out, there is online registration. There's a deal for online. That deal goes for the online registration as well. And you guys come on online registration. For those of you that have already registered for the conference, look for an email from the hostess. I have a bunch of hosts that are helping me, and they should be sending you. You should be getting an email with a link for the private group on Facebook. Is a private group for those that have registered and paid for the conference. Is a private group because of the fact that I would be broadcasting on Zoom for those that are online, so that you will be there live. And if you're having any difficulty at the time of the broadcasting, you will be on the Facebook, the private Facebook group. It'll be broadcasting on there at the same time. So if you have problems like getting in there, you'll have an opportunity to go onto the Facebook page so you can be on the live broadcast if you are registered. So if you come and you try to get on, you're not going to get on unless you're registered to the conference so that you can see the conference. But you will be on Zoom and you will be live in there with us and you will get to see us. I am so looking forward to it. I'm so excited. I'm going to start doing the countdown of days, though, because I am so excited. And then to leave Washington to go into 5,000 degrees of heat in Texas. Woo! Haven't been in the heat in a while. So I'm ready, though. I'm ready. I'm so looking forward to you guys. Those of you that are looking for a coach, I am a coach. You are welcome to contact me at drcarmenbryant@outlook.com. I will provide you with fees for services, the rates that I charge. If you need counseling, you're welcome for counseling. I have a few slots available for counseling. If you are in the state of Washington, if you're outside the state of Washington, I cannot provide you with counseling. If you need counseling, you're outside the state of Washington, go to betterhelp.com/Dr. Carmen. You will get a 10% discount. If you're having financial issues, let them know. They may provide you with the grant. Now, the grant doesn't mean you get it for free. You just get it at a lower fee. And it's a good deal because they actually charge less than what I charge. In general, they charge less than what I charge if you're paying out of pocket to see me as a counselor. So they charge, and it's very, very good rate. It's less than what I charge. But if you guys go to betterhelp.com/Dr. Carmen, I do support them 100% because of the fact that a lot of those counselors do know what they're talking about. And I've heard some very great, great reviews, and I do make commission off of it. But the point is that there are some really good counselors on there that understand narcissist abuse. And I've heard good things from Canada. I've heard good things from people here in the United States. And some of you guys need counseling before you get into coaching. You got to deal with PTSD. When you're looking for a counselor, do you understand PTSD? Do you understand parental alienation? Do you understand the after effects of emotional abuse, psychological abuse? Those are the questions that you ask so they can help you, because many counselors understand all that. When you add in there, like, do you understand what narcissist abuse is? You know, that's not how we're trained. This is extra training that we get, or extra learning that we do to learn about this. We understand the narcissistic personality disorder because we're trained to treat them. And there's no treatment for them, but, you know, we treat them. But normally, most people don't treat the victim or the survivors. And so you ask them questions like that. Ask them DV questions. Ask them domestic violence questions. So once again, I appreciate you guys. Make sure you check out my mother's channel. It is Helen Sadler, Your Destiny Helper. Go on HAPS and you can find my big sister, Kathy Gibson. My Life is Intentional. Pay attention. Stay tuned because her YouTube channel is coming up. And the lady's dynamic. She is. She's dynamic. Then she got a mom right there. The dynamic duo. They are awesome. I'm telling you, to bring up our self-esteem, awesome. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. Stay tuned for tomorrow. I'm trying to get Miss Bridget Griffin on here. I apologize. I'm going to try to get Miss Bridget Griffin on here for live, and so we can do an interview, and then I'll be back live on Sunday at 8 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Sometimes I come in a little late, so usually I come in around 8:30 Pacific Standard Time. And so make sure you tune in, and you guys go and be great, the greatest that you can be, and have a good day. Bye-bye, y'all.